Killers rock with me, little nigga, don't get banged. Cause they undo that job for me while I hop on the plane. She don't like her body, left the doctor with a new shape. Blowing up my phone cause she just see me with my new babe.
What's up, guys? It's Zombie again. Today's story is going to be about my teacher, Mr. Rude. So this story is going to be interesting. Now, this story is going to be about, like, different days and different situations, just because so much happened in this class, and it would just be better to put it all in one video. So it all started in the beginning of my sophomore year of high school. Now, we got to choose our seats in this class, so I chose one next to my cousin, Chenard LeBeau, just because he was, like, the only person I knew in this class. There was also two kids named Aiden right next to us, but I only knew one of them. I wasn't, like, really good friends with him. Now, this class was a computer programming class, so I'm really good with computers, so I thought this class was going to be really easy, and I thought I'd learn a little bit about computer programming, because that's kind of what I wanted to do at the time, so I thought it'd be a good idea. After a few days, Mr. Rude assigned me and Chenard LeBeau a project. Now, me and Chenard LeBeau suck at doing things when we're together. Like, when it comes to school, and you want us to do a project together, it is not a good mixture at all. I think we got about, like, halfway through this project, and then we just said, fuck it, and started, like, messing around in class. I don't even know if we even started on the project now that I think about it. We might have done nothing. But, like, a week or two later, I went into, like, the school, like, grades and shit, and me and Chenard LeBeau got a 90 on this project. And we didn't even do it. So we were confused as shit. So we were just like, all right, this class is going to be an easy A. So a few more days pass and Mr. Rude throws us another project. This time I had to pick three people. Now our friend Aiden went to a different group. So we decided we're going to pick the other Aiden that we barely knew. We didn't even know him actually. So instead of calling him Aiden, we decided to call him Ferdell just because there was another Aiden in the class. So it'd just be easier to call him Ferdell. So Ferdell cares about his grade, but when he was with me and Chenard LeBeau, he started fucking around too. I don't know how this had anything to do with computer programming, but he wanted us to make a project about going on a trip. Now, Chenard LeBeau and Ferdell decided to just start making this project, and I wasn't really doing anything until I noticed they just started making this whole project on Google Slides a meme. They were putting, like, pictures of, like, trampolines and bikes, and it was just, like, the randomest shit they were putting into this project. So we just started making this whole bullshit story that we started off going to the store because I needed a trampoline for some reason, and then I had to get a new bike because Ferdell ran mine over. So this project started everything great about this class, because little did me and Chenard LeBeau know, we just made a great friend. So I'm gonna fast forward a few months. I would walk into class every single day, go up to Ferdell, and just scream, Ferdell! And at this point, we were working on coding. And this day, Ferdell was working on something, and he was trying to learn the coding. Because Mr. Rude was, like, the worst teacher ever. So, like, we had to, like, basically teach ourselves if you actually wanted to, like, get a good grade in this class. So Ferdell is, like, trying to learn how to do this certain, like, coding to make, like, a square box or something, just using coding. Ferdell finally figures it out, and he's like going, I finally figured it out, I can finally do this. And that is when I just shut his computer off, and Ferdell just screams, I didn't save! And me and Chenard just started laughing our ass off. And then after that, for months, I would just be turning Ferdell's computer off when he was trying to work on something. It got to the point where Ferdell was literally holding the power button with his whole palm just so I couldn't click it. So I would just unplug his computer instead. So one time, I turned his computer off, and when it started updating. And while it was updating, I decided to unplug it, which is probably the worst thing you could do while a computer is starting and updating. After that, his computer, every single time you booted it up, it would go to a blue screen. Later on, Mr. Rude comes by and he goes, why is your computer off? And Ferdell goes, I keep getting a blue screen. So Mr. Rude tells Ferdell to move, and he, no joke, decides to move Ferdell right behind me. It was like perfect placement. So at this point, I decided, ooh, I can mess with him harder. Since at the time I knew a lot about computers, I was like, ooh, there's an Ethernet cord. So I unplugged his Ethernet cord, and for like the whole entire class period, he couldn't figure out why he didn't have internet. Mr. Rude later on came by and told him to plug in the Ethernet and that would fix his internet. So a few months later, me and Chenard were sitting there bored out of our minds, and Chenard just makes this bird noise really loud, and Mr. Rude didn't hear it. So I was like, oh, okay. So I decided I'm gonna make some bird noises. And again, Mr. Rude did not hear it at all. So for an entire class period, me and Chenard were literally just making bird calls back and forth, and Mr. Rude said nothing about it. The whole class was just staring at us like we were idiots. At this point, I'm pretty sure Mr. Rude just hated us because all we did was mess around in that class. So I'm gonna skip to another day. One day, I had this orange and I found it in the middle of the hallway on the floor. And I was like, ooh, I can use this. So I walk into Mr. Rude's class. I put the orange right next to Fridell and I said, this is your orange now. And Fridell goes, I don't want this fucking orange. Why would you give this to me? And every time he'd give it back to me, I kept putting it right next to him, next to his computer. Kept saying, take it. It's yours now. That's when Chenard takes the orange and then just accidentally drops it right in front of the class. Now, Mr. Rude, for whatever reason, never goes to the front of the class to tell us something because he was never in front teaching. He was always on his computer. So he goes to the front of the class to teach us something. And that's when he looks down and he goes, ooh, an orange. And this man takes it and walks away. And I was just like, what the fuck? My orange! And then we just started laughing because I literally found this orange in the middle of the hallway. Like, that thing had to be disgusting and full of bacteria and shit. I can't imagine if he actually ate that and got sick. Oh my god. Anyways, let's go on to the next day. So this day, I had a water bottle. Now, I had this water bottle because, no joke, I literally drank like 8 water bottles a day. This entire school year, I was just drinking like 8 water bottles at school. And I was on my second to last one, and then I finished it. That's when I realized I could use this water bottle to fuck around. Now, if you ever drank a water bottle, you know when it's finished, there's still some water at the bottom. So I was just taking the water bottle, and I was just like shaking it and then like spraying it onto Fridell. And Fridell's just over there like, oh my god, what the fuck are you doing? But after doing it so much, there was no more water in the bottle. I took my other water bottle, I poured some of the water into the cap, and then I decided to like put that into the other water bottle that was empty. And then I just started spraying Fridell with it again. Once I got bored, I decided I'm just gonna drink my water bottle. And that's when Fridell started saying something really stupid. He was just like going, bike, 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 to this project. And right after that, I spit all my water out onto the school monitor and all over the keyboard. And then Chenard and Fridell just started laughing so hard because I just spit water everywhere. Now, for the last part of this story, Fridell used to always say something really stupid. Every single day, he had something really stupid to say. I would go on my computer desktop. Every time he said something stupid, I would go to my computer desktop. I'd copy and paste the shortcut to Word, and I would rename the shortcut from Word, and I would just quote him. Now, one of the best quotes I've ever heard from Fridell literally made me and Chenard laugh so hard. So Chenard goes to Fridell and he says, Fridell, what do you do at a stop sign? And Fridell goes, wait for it to turn green? Me and Chenard look at each other and just start laughing so hard. That's when Fridell follows up with, I never took driver's ed. Me and Chenard lost it at this point because you don't need to take driver's ed to know a stop sign can't turn green. It's just common sense that it's a stop sign. But honestly, out of all my school experiences, this class was the best class I've ever been in. And yeah, guys, that's my story. If you want to like the video, please like it. If you want to subscribe, subscribe. And leave a fucking comment. Leave a goddamn comment. That's all I gotta say today. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm out. It's been Zombie. Deuces.